The height differential here, Mitch, 20 centimeters. Takedown! Boom! Shakalaka!
I crotch.
He tried a second attempt at a takedown. Gustavo Balart tries to get on the inside. Olympic wrestler from Cuba. Join the striking tonight. A jump hooking left hand there from Balart. Nice popping right hand from Wada. Overhand left from Balart. Left up again.
He doesn't quite have the, there's a nice little leg tap right here.
Spinning back fist. Uppercut. That one connected. Chin through the top of the head.
Tatsumitsu Wada likes to.
Balart comes after him again. Hunting with that.
Closes that distance. Push kicks right up the middle. There's some straight shots.
Combination lands there.
See, Wada's having a hard time. Maybe a jumping switch knee.
Inflicting damage on Wada. Tatsumitsu Wada. Surprising. Having to punch down.
So this is a very awkward style to
Balart's right eye. Cracking roundhouse kick. Jump walking left hand from Balart on the inside. No takedown attempt still here. Slings the legs. He didn't pounce on Balart. He had an opportunity there.
He was getting picked apart on the feet.
Speed and accuracy there from Wada. On the burners. I really like this one up.
So Wada is dropping his head down. And then which is up until that big knockout. That
nice one from Wada.
I think the jumping is Balart's way to close distance. He might choose a late stage takedown just to maybe score in the judges' eye.
An uppercut from Balart. Can't make it in the close. Balart goes hunting. Another hook off the lead hand from Balart.
He's starting to trade. That's a pretty good head movement.
Final round. Balart hooks him again off the lead. Damage around the right eye, causing some problems here for Balart. Eats a right hand. The lead hooker again, persisting with the right hand.
Puts the jab out there and scores. Look at that, that's three unanswered jabs.
Wada hasn't thrown that jab.
I think that's like the third or the fourth time that knee. Oh, nice two. As he follows it up with a left hand, but then Wada up, puts him down.
Tatsumitsu Wada!
Now Peter Bausch towers over for Lion. Bausch goes up to the forearm. Thank you! Same to Bausch to not
get right into it because he's ultra close. Think that internal
back foot. Got wide.
This point.
The side kicks are ripping that
leg. Tender on his legs, very hard for Bausch to
that left hand to side, a little top of the thigh. Striking seconds off the clock. Lion. Inside the section. Hold it. Chevalo Mitch Johnson came out before. Lion going inside the frame. Huge individual winning streak. So they kick off the Lion. Amir Khan in the strike. Elbow, the spinning back fist. Here tonight on Christian Lee. He's there for the
win. See if he's close that digital line.
The jab. Oh, one strike. Accidental. A clear cut.
It's over and over again. And it looks like it's just
alongside Manny Pacquiao. Head kick! And a right hand from Bausch! That rocks the Lion.
Wow, that head kick was beautiful as he wrapped that foot around the back of the head of Fulbank, but then answered right back up with a right hand. The veteran that he is immediately goes inside the clinch to regain his wits.
That was hoping for a choke.
Watch for the knees.
And he finds a choke at Falaya. Has six submission wins and 16 victories to Peter Bausch.
He's a bit high for the guillotine, but he might be able to make adjustments. Well, hard with that arm in to complete the guillotine. But those long arms are going to give him the ability to make adjustments if necessary.
So in the arena, the crowd would have been quiet when it went to the ground. But now they're an educated grappling crowd in the Philippines. And they're loving this! Balart! Hoping the choke out Balart!
Nice little scramble by Balart to avoid that possible guillotine from Balart. Now Balart's got that front headlock position. Look for the knees.
Balart covers up and here come the knees into the skull of the man from the Netherlands. Balart back to his feet. Knees to the midsection from Balart. Balart with no place to go. Under a minute remaining, first round of three. It's been a back and forth seesaw in conceal aspirations of the Dutchman. Looks for a takedown, doesn't get it. Now spins around, takes the back standing. And now Falayan looks to turn back into him. That's just that. Stylus and big tough lumpy leg kick. Now they tie up. Falayan will go absolutely
can see the pressure. Avoid those knees. Nice tough sweep there.
Now she has wins. Crossing elbow there from Falayan, and Balart throws up those long legs. Hoping to lock and choke here. Hoping for the arm of Falayan. Falayan could be in trouble.
That's what those legs give you. They give you the ability to snatch up arm bars and triangles from very bad position. That triangle choke might be.
Can he do it? This crowd trying to rally behind Falayan. Falling down arm bar now.
Job of controlling the head, maintaining his position.
Opportunities in the second.
Bash has got that underhook on that side. He can start to shrink over.
Open with Falayak. Final 10 seconds. Bash postures up. Tries to land the right. And Edward Falayak says, Edward Falayak. Here comes Bash. Tags him with the right hand. North-south position now. Front headlock from Peter Bell. Can he find a sub? Can he find a finish? Peter Bell just trying. Falayan in trouble. And now gets out of trouble. There's the high knee from Bell.
You can see the equilibrium start to shuffle some cards.
Muay Thai clinch now from Bell. The Muay Thai stylist. No chance for the knees as he drops the knees to Falayan.
Legs of Peter Bell because he doesn't want to eat another one of those head kicks.
Falayan, then the side kick.
Beautiful by Edward Falayan to catch that kick. That was a pivotal takedown, much needed in the dying back up to his feet.
Peter Bell!
Christian Lee, are you watching?
The head and spine, you both know the rules. Fight fair, fight clean.
Norwegian talent in one championship these days. Annalena Hogstad, of course. And that's more like it from Namo. Although it landed just
time came around that 3 minute mark when he was going forward, he got the dirty boxing, he started to grab, but we're not really seeing any sort of check hooks or anything coming from Normo just coming in swinging those mallets at Ngalani, but good head movement, but he got caught.
These are wild looping shots. There's the knee. And you see there, the knee came up to the midsection, but the leg is so long, the knee. Ngalani, a seasoned veteran, inside leg to a high.
Could have plucked him straight out of.
Gotta wonder what pressure and what burden that Ngalani takes. Goes head
high. Those kicks just to keep his kicking strategy.
The cup sound. A little lower there. Does Ngalani then go? Ngalani palm goes to Ngalani. What a bad tactic.
Graphic channel Vikings.
Good overhand right from Ngalani. Uppercut to a right hand from
like that. Whenever Galani's
person that he's in there with
looks like a super heavyweight. Galani's usually the biggest
out of these two. With all of his the sheer size of Namo, who also gives up experience often the recipient of
that knee again. He's got to make sure he curls that.
Namo plenty
to think. Right hand, nice and clegged. He's trying to touch up that lead leg.
Namo trying to cross the movement here, Mitch.
Yeah, this is what Normo has to do. He has to get nice and tight, get that close, keep that pressure on Galani. He's doing. He's got a
bodyguard. When he retires from fighting, going up against the experience of Ngalani, who has side control.
Not overextending Alain in the opening 5 minutes.
Good work out of that southpaw position.
And that is a worry. If you're the leg there was Ngalani. Ngalani, front kick to clockwise. Overhand right from Ngalani. Round kick to the three, straight up in his stance.
He curls that foot in, makes that knee nice and tight. Yellow card, now he's got to push.
From Ngalani, didn't have the muscle.
Namo lumbering that forward. Power, and then Ngalani switches back to orthodox.
He wants some sort of vengeance on the other guy.
Nice little running in again with that lunging, punching style. I think that
it can you're sort of take over in the very long kickboxing champion, multi-time. This guy has been around
kicked there a lot,
so he kind of, you know, he's used to how to deal with it, and you can see that it's not.
He let him up a moment ago from this position. Will he do so again? Slings the legs a little. These long tree trunks of the Norwegian corner saying to Alain, keep going, keep kicking his legs, you're going to hurt him. And indeed, those shins are taking a battering now. Momo's hurt.
On the legs. And you can see that the way Normal was trying to move. And I think...
Yeah, that'll do it.
That could have been it right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to an unintentional foul, the athlete is unable to continue. Therefore, this match has been declared a no contest.
Thai type kickboxing and punches.
Very relaxed style. He likes to come out
because you can see there those elbows go.
Keeping that guard nice and high, protecting, you know, a grappler. But Chan Rotana doesn't think he's going to be grappled. Shoots in and gets a nice takedown.
We are seeing crowds all around Asia improving their knowledge here to technical MMA, and the crowd loved that takedown. Just past the 2 minute mark in this opening round, and Siabin
punching underneath the arm there, looking for the chin, but getting mainly body. But he's got the back of his opponent, and he throws him down like a.
There on the arm, but he's Rotana's got his hand trapped there.
What can
Siabin's
he do?
Siabin's got so much reach, his arms are so long.
For a band. If he can make use of that proper effective use throughout his career, then he's got a successful time ahead of him. He's got to be careful with that punch to the back of the head. A tremendous takedown, though. And he looks for the back once more. An illegal blow is when a punch doesn't make a connection to either touch an ear. That's legal.
See this wrestling game left on there. Rotana knee on belly now. Postures up. Rotana uses it to transition out. Might be able to get a takedown of his own now.
1-2 as a professional, 3-2 in the ONE Championship cage. Got his hands full here.
That's some good wrestling from Siabin.
Oh, knee to the head.
Pin the leg down, he uses it to stand back up. Now he takes him back down to the mat. Now he's got side control.
Is that a guillotine that could threaten a stoppage, Mitch?
Nah, because he's out in side control. Siabin's got both knees on the side there.
Right.
He doesn't have any sort of leverage.
His head so out. He's just... Chan Rotana walking along the cage, not allowed to grip it with his toes, but you can walk.
Implement anything new from the pin, immediately starts to back out. He's just kind of leading to a little bit of hesitancy on his part for just that exact reason. Beautifully ducked under, slid into the one arm, the right arm trapped between his legs, and he's able to control Chan Rotana's left arm with his arms as well. Here comes a darce choke. He's able to slide into there with that long reach. I don't know if you can see it, but now he's grasped his own bicep, and he's getting deep into an anaconda-type choke there.
I'm not sure that Chan Rotana has had a hand to tap out with for a moment there, although it's free now, but that is looking pretty tight, Mitch, isn't it?
Yeah, he's got a little bit of space on one side, but that's really tight.
He's tapped,
oh,
it's over.
Beautiful.
Yuji Shimada was there looking very careful.
The back of the head, watch all over, no contact with the hands, no contact with the
hands. Back over. I kick from the right. Over. Tonight. World title. Both engagements. Our process at the moment here. Mei Yamaguchi over
that range. He's got to try to get. He's having a hard time dealing with it.
Very clean and cool. Finds myself the school of the martial arts, and it's great to have one championship here for the very first time.
Single leg, double leg. There she goes, trying to get that double leg. Now her hands are almost locked. Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her legs separated and also using the overhooks.
Very first time in Japan. Turned around here from Lachkova. Backs Yamaguchi against the fence. Crossing elbow from the Russian. Now it's Yamaguchi's turn.
Nicely underneath the arms of Lachkova. And Lachkova has such good balance and that reach advantage, height advantage. She's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts by Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi has to keep her back pressed up against the cage.
Step up to the biggest stage of all, the largest martial arts organization in the world.
Press her up against the cage, and now is doing very well inside the cage.
20 seconds remains. There's the right hand. Now loading. Traditional martial artist out of Japan against the Pancration World Champion. Takedown by Yamaguchi. 1 foot on hip, and that's how the round ends. It's come a whole way to martial arts champions.
near the 130 inside leg kick, missed the target.
Dude, she has to make this dirty. She's got to get close. She's got to make it dirty. Throw that right hand. That's it. Get nice and tight in the posture, nice and high, and keep it from dropping down. She's even trying to lace these legs and go for the takedown. Watch Cobra Maya grab the takedown there. She was trying to pin down one of these arms, look for an armbar.
Yep, there she goes. Throw the hips up.
And as we see, this is a bit high on the arm. You can see the elbow is almost out. She might be able to pop it out, but she's got to, you know, because of the length of Machkova, she's able to.
Still against Demetrius Johnson. Big lineup, big night for Japan. Two punches, then one to two later on in the form of Timofey Nastukin taking on Eddie Alvarez. Don't sleep on Nastukin. When he goes beast mode, Eddie Alvarez had better keep his hands up.
Good ground and pound coming from Mei Yamaguchi. Very calculated strategy here on the ground. A lot of effective ground and pound coming from Yamaguchi. It's a mystery.
From Yamaguchi coming out of it. There it is.
Gustavo left chin, and that's been able to
count the right hand over the front. Onto the back. Now it's time to the final round with the right hand. There's a double leg from Yamaguchi. And five remains. Third and final round, Russia versus Japan, as Lachkova tries to lock on for an arm.
Finally able to get it. She was looking for it the entire time, but looks like Yamaguchi is able to use Lachkova's attempted triangle to get the pass, and now sits inside side control.
Over the shoulder head. And this crowd is loving it every time Yamaguchi lands. Leave a pitch here in Tokyo.
Through the half guard, just like that, and sit into mount and take the back, possibly here. Lachkova looking for armbar.
Armbar from VV Mei Yamaguchi. Is she going to tap her out? In the third and final round, yes, she does.
Got the headbutt, back of the head and spine. Fight fair, fight clean. Dutch gloves.
Oh, Ramazanov, nice fake step jab combination there.
You see how high he lifts his hands?
Clockwise now. Good counter right hand on the top of Pongsari's head. There's one of the forearms.
Steps forward with the feint, then switches stances to the next stance. Pongsari needs to find his really to have any sort of offense. Because if you're in Ramazanov's kicking range, I mean, what's, you know, Pongsari going to do? Send a telegram? Get anywhere near him?
There's just no Ramazanov. Everything he does is at full extension. Downward strike there off the right hand. Return the favor. Looking to cut off the circle, but
coming from Ramazanov. I wouldn't mind seeing him go to the legs. Just start beating on the
better view Ramazanov. Looking to expose that tape kick.
Hands as well. But because of the long range style, see how he's in and out? He basically takes a big step.
And he throws them. There's the long front.
He's firing. You can see Pongsari trying to walk him down, trying to slow down that movement. And this is what we've seen Pongsari do in the past. He's just kind of a slow starter, just to kind of warm up and read his opponent. Ramazanov doesn't start the same way. It's going to be important for Ramazanov to come out.
Pongsari calling him forward, catch and counter. That is round kick from Ramazanov.
See, Pongsari's got a really tight guard, Michael. It's really hard to get through. You got to come up the middle with uppercuts and really start attacking the body, because his legs and his body are going to be Ramazanov's really keys to taking this first round. But he's also a lot more active. Look how much volume he's already throwing.
It's that triangle guard of Pongsari. You see the way the fists are closer together, then the elbows flare out from the body, creating that triangle.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to go to the body. I'd like to see him start digging. He's beating on the calf of Ramazanov.
Oh, the uppercut! Boom! The uppercut, the diesel piston off the right hand. Pongsari's gone!
Look at that. Feints. Yeah, those feints. And then the uppercut on the right hand touches him right on the butt. Hitting that with a two punch. And then the third drops it. Click, click, boom! In 4 ounce gloves.
Around, okay? It's okay. It's okay.
From Thailand.
Is Mad Dog gonna utilize that? Since that jab is gonna be it. He's got world hands.
140 martial arts world. Towering some 12 centimeters taller in the steel locomotive. Catching sweep there.
That leg a little bit longer than he's supposed to.
Work. We saw the superb leg kicks of the steel.
Inside the clinch, you have to be active. You have to be throwing elbows and knees and punches.
His gym name, hence he's called Rodlek PK Sanchai Muay Thai. Front kick there was more of a punt kick from
Rodlek. Trying to gauge that distance. Not going small heavy. Gloves.
Robinson's 40 losses and 5 two-time world champion. Mad Dog Miller, the Scottish champ, Mad Dog Miller. Good outside leg kick from the Scotsman.
Similar names, similar styles. Along with the Rodtang has.
Rodtang has done such amazing performance.
Basket, Rod Leg quickly gets back to center in. Catching counter perhaps. No, just misses to get the push kicks to the midsection. And then when he's ready, when he sees an opening, come flying through with those knees. And also with those elbows. Here are the knees now from Mad Dog Miller.
Rodnick starting his legs, really slow his opponent down with those leg kicks.
Good kick to the off to his left to cut off the ring movement. Go to the outside lead thigh. Miller clinches up with him. A chance for the Rodnick go to the legs again. Turner was off to his right. Trying to stay away from the power side of the
Miller
steel.
Through that right high kick. A little bit on the chin there. A little bit more ump into it. Step forward a little
just
bit
above the lead knee, which effectively deadens
the. I'm not seeing those jabs. I'm not seeing those push kicks. And Miller can't stand there.
And kick the lead thigh. You see the reddening of the thighs there of the Scotsman from Andrew Miller. Rodnick goes to the body. Then the
setting up those bodies with the jab and then stepping in.
Look how Rodnick cuts off the movement again. Pulls the arrow. Pulls the arrow on Andrew Miller. You often see the rematch by crew Ram Moy. You often see it employed actually during the round. A moment of rest for both these men to open the third and inside leg kick from Rodnick. Left hook to the right hand for the power side, the right side, it's a short popping overhand.
The hands of Rodnick by initiating that curl. He actually wants to shut down the arms and draw him in.
Oh, smack bang! He caught him with a short right hand, smack bang to the kisser! Andrew Miller's down! He's on rubber legs, he's doing the chicken dance! And it's over!
Rodnick. Okay? No pinch. Okay? Okay?
Sonny Sama playing mind games with us. Right, I've got Askarov trying. Won't be sucking into anything though. You see again, Sama wants Askarov to. He backs off Askarov. The double forearms guard, the high checks for.
Opportunity, uppercuts.
Askarov's gonna go off the fence here. Here comes Sonny Sana with the right hand and a high knee.
Cerebral footwork from Sonny.
The range of Sana's shots.
Left to a left. Stay there, Jabba. Askarov throws the right. See again, he comes off the movement and there's a right. He calls Melbourne, Australia, home. They're in the audience tonight here in Bangkok, including Zigzag. Round kick to a right hand from Sana. Outside leg kick, Sana. Askarov down. Three judges, circle side, score 19. To get a
you're saying that's Askarov's only chance.
Sana thought about switching, goes down to the right, isn't working for Genghis Khan Sana. And there's one inside to the job.
And trust me, Askarov could
wear the FC in.
Askarov will want to get on the inside.
Sana early.
Of Askarov trying to finish with Sonny Sana. Just the low kick. Sonny Sana. In reality, series they're open here. Sana thought about switching. Goes down to the finals. I think Welber from inside the circle. Askarov not going back. Got to find a way to bridge the.
Sana wants sure he stays in front of him. Might be working to Sana.
Sana was taller than Askarov.
Using the entire circle, what he believes could be his.
Forcing Askarov problems. Tapped here. And is it challenge Angela? Sami Sana comes up in his head. He wants the rising knee. Third and final round.
Suck it in. Does he get dirty with it?
His range is not. Unofficially on first round. Second round, 10. Askarov's got to change it up here. Long time.
I think he irritated him a long time. Obliging to you. Dirty's trying to throw shots. And Sana lost it.
A whole different athlete, Askarov. Five rebounds. Jabba Askarov to somehow. Jack from Askarov. He's really doing it all right. Even the guard has been impenetrable. There's the reach again of Sonny Sana. The
legs of Jabba don't seem to be understanding it. He's trying to move around.
In the championship century, shooting to circle counterclockwise.
Sonny Sana!
A phenomenal performance. Sana, the first man through to the final.
Be strong, be fair, obey my instructions all the time.
Upset by a lot of
the riddle of Jotzenkleid.
All the punches with their face.
Johnson Cry goes to the jaw of Senna. A right hand from Senna. A step through knee again. Throws the knee again. To go.
But has he got that second round was ultra close. Like you just said, the crowd 10-8 coming from the first round.
So many people's over kicks on Sami Senna. The right hand again from Senna. Johnson Cry trying to get through. Trying for the knockout punch. The knockout right has kicked. Who will semi-final with Jabir Askarov? Who will move a closer step to US $1 million? Mitch, this is just ferocious. This is ferocious.
I like how God's using that. He's let his hands drop. He's so comfortable. He relies on his power.
The right hand to Johnson. There's a left hook from Jan on the uppercut. This is a battle. Close to drop, but it didn't happen for the tie. And here they go again. Flashes of 2-1 in Fukuoka. Martin Rose in an all-time K1 classic. Races of an all-time 1 Super Series. Shot from Johnson Lee from Sami Senna. He's got to be smart now. Stand in that phone booth and let Sami punches on you. Body shot from Yacht.
This is when it's more than guts. It's fortitude.
It's that Bushido spirit, Mitch.
Man, they are just trained. You can see the
2,800 people in his last. Sami used the reach on his inside. Flies left hand. Flies left round.
Nice and tight to Yacht's face. That was just 19% height advantage.
Taking his time. Off by trying to find legs of the Dalton Clyde. Doubles up to the lead leg. And there's the left hand of Yacht. Johnson will close in to make it featherweight to unlock Johnson tonight and tuck.
Also use that right kick of leg, go up time over and over. Time was for just 20 body.
Yod just defending. Go to Senna, tried to connect with the right hand. That being the jab of the Senna, thrust up the kick. Roundhouse kick off the back. Who will advance to face Jabir?
This jab right
now. Hitting path against Yod at age 10 years. Senna with the uppercut, double forearms guard, Senna. For Yod's how he recovers him. Breaks now from Yod. We'll see turn up the artillery. Especially off that back leg and he cracks him in Senna. Jab from Yod.
It all go.
Go to the body. Stop. This isn't Muay Thai.
Good balance shown by Yod there. He's able to stay up on his feet.
Johnson Clyde goes to the body. Senna throws the uppercut. Johnson Clyde. It's been a while in the gloves. As I said, previously loving this.
Johnson
Clyde. It's the upset.